This has been a tough year, an unprecedented year for everyone.
We are all grieving today. We are grieving the loss of life and the reality that the foundations of our democracy appear shaky at best.
The pandemic.
COVID-19.
The COVID-19 pandemic.
Virtually everything about who has gotten sick and who has not, who has gotten effective treatment and who has not, these all are the products of the society the virus has encountered and the policies that govern our society.
Gun violence, police violence against Black and Brown people, violence against Asian American communities.
Insurrection at the Capitol.
The U.S. Code defines insurrection. It was not just a riot. It was an assault on Congress in the middle of the joint session.
We are in a moment of tremendous crisis about whether there would be a handover of power.
And yet, even in a year defined by isolation and distance, people came together in solidarity on our screens and in the streets to join in a historic and ongoing movement for racial justice. As we look to the year ahead, new challenges already await us.
Our mission is to ensure the integrity of our democracy, because it is at its best when every eligible vote can be counted and when every voice can be heard.
The Supreme Court is taking up a case that could overturn Roe versus Wade. More states are passing legislation to deny transgender identity, dignity, and health. And climate change is an increasing threat to our communities. So many of these challenges call for hard truths about our laws and legal systems and whom they really serve.
But we are especially focusing our work in this anniversary year on our Constitution's founding failures when it comes to race and equality in this country, and reckoning with our past to create a more just future.
The 13th Amendment abolishes slavery and involuntary servitude, but permits involuntary servitude to the extent that it is a punishment for crime. And we have the immediate attempt during Reconstruction to make Black synonymous with criminal.
Part of the declarations of racism as a public health crisis, some communities are putting in reparations, right? So Asheville, North Carolina, California, Evanston, and Illinois.
It is a time for transformative change.
We are lawyers, students,
scholars,
advocates,
elected officials,
and voters.
Together, we will advocate for court reform
and insist on a judiciary that reflects the diverse public it serves.
We will work to restore our democratic legitimacy and advance civil rights.
We will mobilize the legal community in support of a truth, racial healing, and transformation commission to ensure a future that is different from our past. Together, we are the American Constitution Society.